Good evening, family. So great that you all can join us. Andre Hetsa, Renai Khonsi, Hai Khonsi, Johan, Jocelyn, Marco, Mariska, Belinda, Estelle, welcome, welcome. Lusanne, welcome. Liesel, welcome. Thanks for joining us. We are looking forward to tonight. I'm trusting that after this week's power prayer that you feel empowered, amen, and that you have a boldness and a stirring within your spirit, and that you have become excited about what God is going to do for South Africa, amen. Let me tell you, this is not the end, this is only the beginning, amen. Remember what I told you, sometimes before we can go to new heights, there's first new depths, amen. But when we get through those deep times, those difficult times, the next high is just higher, and I believe that is for South Africa, amen. For South Africa will live and South Africa will have revival. Amen. This is not the end. Amen. We serve a very, very good God. Kathy, welcome. Eric, welcome. Kensani, welcome. We miss you all. Let me tell you, I miss the fellowship. Jeanette, welcome. Marley, welcome. Shani, welcome. Truly miss the fellowship with you all, but thanks the Lord in the Spirit, there's no distance. Amen. I thank you for praying also this week with us. Cornelius, welcome. Henny, welcome. Tian, welcome. And it's, who's that? Reaper. Hello, Reaper. Welcome, Ria, welcome. Thanks for joining everybody. You know what? I just want you, maybe you've had a busy or a rough day. I just want you now to close your eyes where you're sitting, whether it's in your pajamas, in your bed, on your couch. Doesn't matter, maybe you're still working. I just want you just to take a moment, close your eyes and just focus on God and just release the day. Maybe it's been a difficult or a challenging week. I just need you to put your focus back on God and just leave those things that is a burden and heavy to you. Just leave it at His feet tonight. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, today we come, we surrender this day, we surrender this week, we surrender everything to you, Lord. Lord, we pray tonight, Lord, and we surrender our prayers, Lord, that our prayers come from our spirits, Lord, and led by the Spirit of God, Lord, and not be fleshly prayers, Lord, that you will teach us how to pray, Lord. Lord, that you will stir our spirits, Lord. Revive us, Lord. Revive us, Lord. Every person that's joining in prayer now, Lord, I pray that you will activate a hunger deep within them for you, Lord. A hunger that cannot be quenched, Lord. Let them hunger for your word, for prayer, and for your presence, Lord. Lord, I pray for an increase in their prayer life, Lord, that you will give them an increase, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the privilege that we can gather in prayer, even if it's online, but that we can gather in the Spirit and stand together in unity, Lord. I thank you for unity and oneness in our prayers tonight, Lord, as we glorify you, bring you all the glory, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Lord, we pray tonight for your perfect will, Lord, for your perfect will to be prayed, Lord. And Lord, we thank you and we surrender now our obedience to you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Sebra katala la baba barakusha baba barakuse. Kela la 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 rakatara babusha baba barakutara baraba hano la 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 rabusubra katara baba barakusto. Kere katatara babusha baba, Lord. Let every ear be open tonight, Lord, for your voice, Lord, and every heart be open to receive, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for a fresh impartation into our spirits tonight, Lord. Lord, I pray that you'll touch every person there where they are now in their house, Lord. Just fill them afresh with the Holy Spirit, Lord. Just fill them afresh. You know what? Maybe you can't yet speak in your heavenly language. I want you to trust the Lord, because why not now? Amen. Jesus, I pray now that the persons watching tonight, Lord, even if they have not been baptized by your Spirit, Lord, that you will baptize them now with the Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Sibra baba barukusha baba bahunarika tadaraba barukusta babaruka la la kabaruko. Zela la rabasha baba bakutarika la 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 honoriba baba barabusuba la 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 katerebushimurkusto. Geraka tadaraba baba barukushobarkusola la ka. Lord, tonight we are coming together in unity, Lord, as believers, Lord, seeking your face, Lord. Lord, we are desperate for you, Lord. Lord, we need you. We are dependent on you, Lord. South Africa needs you, Lord. Lord, we need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. Lord, we pray now and we stand in the gap on behalf of every South African, Lord. And Lord, we repent of our sins, Lord, of our wrongdoings, Lord, of our disobedience, Lord. Where South Africa may have rejected you, might have rejected your ways, Lord. Lord, we repent of those things, Lord. We repent of the ungodly laws allowed in South Africa, Lord. We repent, Lord. We come in disagreement with those laws, Lord. Lord, we come in disagreement with every ungodly spirit which South Africa has taken hands with, Lord. Lord, we rebuke such spirits, Lord. We rebuke them now in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. Forgive us our sins, Lord. Come and cleanse us, Lord. Lord, come and restore your righteousness in South Africa, Lord. Lord, we pray now that the people will seek your righteousness, Lord. That they will turn away from wicked ways, Lord. Lord, let them not call evil good and good evil, Lord, but that they will call upon the name of the Lord, Lord. Let the people be able to recognize your voice. Open the ears of the people, Lord. Lord, soften their hearts again, Lord. Lord, soften our hearts for each other, Lord. Fill our hearts of compassion for one another, Lord. Lord, we pray that you'll bring unity in South Africa, restoration, healing, and peace. Your peace, Lord. Not a false peace, Lord, but your peace. Lord, I pray that the fear of the Lord will strike every heart of every South African, Lord. Lord, we declare, Lord, that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that you are God, that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, the only way, and the Savior, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We call upon deliverance for South Africa, Lord. Deliver us, Lord. Deliver us from the evil ones, Lord. That is our prayer, Lord. Lord, we pray that you'll expose every darkness within this nation, Lord. Every spirit of corruption, Lord. That you'll break those bondages and those agreements, Lord. We come in unity tonight, Lord. Lord, we pray against disorder and unrest in this nation, Lord. We pray against civil war, Lord. Civil unrest, Lord. We nullify it. We bind it in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, we declare your peace, your peace. Lord, you have the final say on South Africa, Lord. And we declare that South Africa will live. We declare peace in this nation, Lord. We declare peace in this nation, Lord. We declare God's rule in this nation, Lord. Your ways in this nation, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Sebra baba baruku shuna la raba baruku sohota raba baruku. Sela la raba baba shaburuku tala la 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 hobra baba baruku shte. Sebra kaba baba baruku subra baba baruku sula la 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 hobra baba shaburuku sta. Sebra kona na raba baba baruku la baba hobruku shte. Sera kata la la baba baruku la 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 baba baraya no na reche dora baba baruku sta.
In Proverbs 9 verse 10, that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. Lord, I pray that the fear of the Lord will return back into your church, Lord, will return back into South Africa, this nation, Father, that they will once again realize that we were born to worship you, we were born to serve you, Lord, that we were born, Father God, to carry out the purpose that you have given us, Father God. And I just pray for a fresh new urgency upon your people's hearts, Lord, to seek you fresh and new again, Lord. A fresh fire, Father, in the name of Jesus.
We receive it, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, come now against every agent of fear that is operating in this nation. You spirit of fear, we bind your works now in the name of Jesus Christ. You spirit of fear, we cast you out in the name of Jesus. Go to the abyss now in the name of Jesus. Wherever I cannot, you know what, every night we've been pretty much praying for against a spirit of fear. Why? Because a spirit of fear has grabbed a whole nation. Actually, not just a whole nation of South Africa, but the whole world. And let me tell you that it is not okay. Amen. If you are making decisions because you're being manipulated by people around you, workplace, government, doesn't matter who it is, it is not okay. If you are making decisions today in your life because or out of a place of fear, God does not operate from a place of fear. Amen. You will not hear His voice out of a place of fear. Amen. I need you now to repent where you've allowed a spirit of fear to operate in your life or that of your family. You need to repent now and come in disagreement with that spirit so that spirit can leave you and your house. Amen. Because fear redirects a future. You do not want to make your decisions out of fear. Amen. You want God to have the final say in your future, not a spirit of fear, because Satan uses fear to change people's direction. Do not allow it. He's using fear to change the direction of South Africa. He will not succeed because God has the final say. Amen. And we say no more. No more to a spirit of fear. Amen. Kick him out of your house. What is fear doing in the house of Christians today? I'm asking you this. What is fear doing in your house? It's a spirit from the enemy, not a spirit from God. For God's word says, for He did not give us a spirit of fear, but of sound mind. I'm asking you today, how many people have challenges with mental struggles? It's not okay. The suicides that we are seeing that's happening and on the increase, it is not okay. Children, teenagers, fearing for their future, it is not okay. It is the work of the enemy, amen? And we rebuke that spirit of fear. If you see it over your children, rebuke it. Chase that thing out of your house. Amen. Do not allow the enemy to operate in your home. Amen. So I just need you to pray with me. You know, we all read the media. We all see what's going on in our nation. We see the protests. We see the unrest. We see COVID. We see people dying around us. But we cannot let fear enter through those gates. Amen. Let us close those doors to the enemy now. I just need you to pray with me. Amen. Let's come in agreement as believers and stand tonight and kick that thing out. Lord, tonight I come in the mighty name of Jesus. And we pray and we ask that you forgive us, Lord, where we have allowed this spirit of fear to operate in our life. Lord, tonight we give the spirit an eviction notice to go now in the name of Jesus. No more in the name of Jesus. For God has given us a spirit of peace, amen, not a spirit of fear, amen, amen. Lord, I declare now a spirit of boldness to come upon every person, Lord. Peace, a sound mind, Lord, as your word promises now, now in the name of Jesus. Declare with me, I have a sound mind. Amen. And not a spirit of fear. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord. Michelle, will you please pray for us for discernment and wisdom? It is such a critical thing that we need in this day and age. Amen. Not just us, but leadership. Everybody is in need of this. Just pray for us, please.
I just want to share a scripture on that. In James chapter 1 verse 5, it is written, if any of you lacks wisdom to guide him through a decision or circumstances, he is to ask of God our Father who gives to everyone. I mean, God does not pick and choose who he gives it to. If you ask him, he will give it to you. So if you have a circumstance or a decision to make and you do not know what to do, just seek God and ask him to guide you through that. So Father, Lord Jesus, we come in this evening, Lord, and we pray for discernment and wisdom in this night, that you will impart it into your children, that you will impart it into your church, Father God. During this time of having to make decisions and having to go through circumstances, Father, we pray for your discernment and your wisdom, Father, so that we will know what to do and that we will know what is from you and what is not, Father, that we will know your voice and that we will know when you speak to us and that we will obey, Father God. I pray for the grace also, Father God, to be able to go through with your instruction, Lord, that we will not care about what people say, but if you give us the guidance and the wisdom and the discernment, that we will pull through with it, Father, and that we will not get that we will not feel uncomfortable to such an extent where we just leave everything that we are busy with and just disobey you, Father God. We pray, Lord, that we will come in all obedience to you, and we decree and declare, Father, that everything that you instruct us, Father, that your church will stand strong, that your believers will stand strong, and that they will push through, Father. We pray for wisdom and discernment in the government and the leadership and the pastors, Father, that they will know what to do, Father, that they will hear your voice clearly, Lord, that they will know that this is what God wants us to do and this is what we shall do. Father, for too long we have been silent, for too long we have been hiding. So I decree and declare that this shall be our portion. This shall be the portion of your children, your believers, your church, and your leaders, Father. We decree and declare this in your almighty name.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I also need you to repent now where you've been disobedient to God, because you know what? Fear of man leads to disobedience to God. Amen. I also need you to close that door in your life, because obedience is vital for us as children of God, so that the perfect will of God can manifest in our lives. So wherever you've been disobedient, it might have been that fear was the root of that, because fear of man leads to disobedience. Amen. And I just need you to loose that thing over your life now and make right with God. Amen. Lord, forgive us all where we have been disobedient, Lord. Forgive us, Lord, where we did not listen to your Spirit, Lord, where we have rejected your words, Lord. We pray that you will forgive us, Lord. Lord, where our future has been negatively altered, Lord, we cancel it out in the mighty name of Jesus. And we declare the promises of God of our lives to be yes and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Nadine, will you please pray for us, for the leaders and for the government, please? Lead us in prayer.
Father, as we come before you right now, we stand in the gap of the leaders and the governments of this nation, Father. We declare that you will strike a fear of the Lord within their hearts, Father, that they would come to know you as the one true living God. We pray right now, Father, that their hearts to be softened and turned towards you, Father. We pray right now, God, that you would give them a godly wisdom right now. We pray that the godly leaders in the government would arise and take their stand. Right now, we also pray, Father, that the church would find favor with the government and with the leaders, Father. We pray that their hearts would be turning towards the church and towards you, Father. We thank you right now for this in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, I also pray for this country, this nation, Lord, that it will be like just as in Proverbs 21, verse 1, saying the king's heart is in the hands of the Lord. Like the rivers of water, he turns it wherever he wishes. Father, I pray, Lord, that you will come and touch this nation, Lord. I pray that you will come and touch our leadership, Father. Wherever there's corruption, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will cast it out, Lord, that your light will be casted upon all darkness, Father God, that it will expel all darkness in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will raise up a leadership, you will raise up a government, Lord, whose hearts are close to you, Lord, whose hearts are burning for that which your heart is burning for, Lord. A government, Father, that puts Christ first, who puts God first, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. A government that will lift up the name of Jesus above every other name in this country, in this nation, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, I also come and I pray for the nation, Lord. I pray for the salvation of this nation. You say in Psalms 22 that all nations will remember you, that all families will turn back to you and bow down, for yours is the glory, for yours is the dominion, Father. And we declare it over every household in this evening, in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have got family that you know and you are praying for, that you've been praying for so long that they would give their hearts to Jesus, I want you to lift up your hands and start praying, start decreeing and declaring over them. Lord, I pray that you would touch their hearts, Lord. You say, Lord, that the harvest is plentiful. Lord, here we are, send us. Use us, Father. Send us out into the world, Lord. From the east, the south, to the west, Father. Use us for your glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, that every family will remember the name of Jesus, and that it will be true when we say that we in our houses, we shall serve the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Today we declare that the righteousness of God would rain down upon this nation, and that your righteousness should spring up in every home, to spring up in every community, Father, right now in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I also pray that you will arrest your children with your spirit, Lord, that they will call upon your spirit, Lord, that you will give them visions and dreams, Lord, and guide every step, Lord, that you will guide the steps of the body of Christ, Lord. Let them hear your voice clearly, Lord, and respond with obedience, Lord, and fear for the Lord, Lord. I pray, Lord, that every pastor, every minister, every apostle, Lord, every minister within this nation, Lord, Lord, that you will cover them with your blood, Lord, your protection, put an edge of protection around them, Lord. Send your angels forth to be with them, Lord, Lord, so that they may, Lord, walk in freedom and liberty, Lord, and proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ fearlessly and boldly, Lord. Let nothing, Lord, alter their way, Lord. Let they will not be dismayed, Lord, but that they will be encouraged and strengthened through the Spirit of God, Lord. Let your Spirit rest upon them, Lord. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you'll give a fresh infilling of your oil upon each minister's head, Lord. That you will anoint them, Lord. Anoint them afresh, Lord, to lead, Lord. Lord, we declare now, Lord, Lord, that you will take them, Lord, deeper and further with you, Lord, that you will teach them, Lord, that you will teach their hands how to war in the spirit in this day and in this age, Lord. We call them forth to be the men and the women of God you have called them to be, Lord, to lead your people, Lord. Lord, I pray now, Lord, that a unity will come upon the body of Christ, upon the churches, Lord, no matter the pastors, the ministers, the denominational churches, let it not matter, Lord, that those little petty things no longer matter, Lord, but that you will unify us, Lord, through your spirit, Lord, that you will raise up your body, Lord, Lord, to be a mighty warrior in this nation, Lord. Let the church use the two-edged sword, Lord, to bring your truth to this nation, Lord, and to cut away everything in this nation that is not from you, Lord, to bring forth deliverance in this nation, Lord, to usher in revival through your spirit, Lord. We declare revival within every church, within every house, within every person now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We declare it now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we also come now and we pray, Lord. We pray and we seek your face, Lord, and we ask you, Lord, let us not lose our freedom of religion, Lord, that you will fight on our behalf, Lord, that you will turn this weapon formed against this church around, Lord, Lord, that it shall not prosper against the church, Lord. Lord, we declare now, Lord, all the ungodly laws be broken, Lord, nullified in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. The agents and the people or the evil wicked spirits sitting behind us, that be exposed now in the name of Jesus. Let every trap of the enemy catch its owner in the name of Jesus. We declare it, Lord. Lord, I pray against persecution. Lord, so many pastors and believers have been persecuted, not just by government or certain officials, Lord, but even by fellow believers, Lord. We come against that spirit trying to bring destruction and division. You spirit of division, we break your power now in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not prosper. You will not prosper. Lord, we come now, those tongues against the body of Christ, against the believers, Lord, we shut it in the name of Jesus Christ. Those slanderous spirits, we bind your works now in the name of Jesus Christ. Those false accusations against the body of Christ, we bind it now in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. We bind it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you will force the enemies of the body of Christ, of the church, to be in peace with us, Lord. Lord, that they will surrender, Lord, because whoever is an enemy of God is our enemy, Lord. God first, Lord. We will declare God first, always and first most, Lord. You are the final authority, Lord. You have the final say, Lord. We thank you, Lord. I've got a scripture. Proverbs chapter 16 verse 7 says, when people's lives please the Lord, even their enemies are at peace with them. Lord, may the body of Christ's lives be pleasing to you, Lord. Lord, let us find favor in your sight, Lord, so that our enemies may be in peace with us, Lord. We declare it now, Lord, the peace of the Lord. Thank you, Lord. The peace of the Lord within the body of Christ, Lord. The peace of the Lord in the church and the peace of the Lord in this nation. Thank you, Lord. Pastor Yonai, will you pray for us against this lockdown? You know, there has been such negative effects of this lockdown. Please just pray for us.
Father, we come tonight in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, and I just lay every business, Father God, I just feel like praying for the businesses right now that has been affected by this lockdown, Lord. I pray for your restoration in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, you say in your word that when we worship you, you will come and restore, you will come and heal, Father. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you will release your blessing over every business in this region, Lord, in this nation, in this country, Lord, wherever the enemy is stolen, I declare that you will give back, Father God, sevenfold in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you will impart strength unto them, Lord, your strength. You say that you are strong, therefore you want us to be strong, Lord. I pray that you would impart your strength into us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I come against any plan, any device the enemy has planned against the church and the body of Christ through using this lockdown, Father. We have seen the lie. We have seen what you have tried, what you are trying to do, enemy, and we command you right now in the name of Jesus to stop what you're doing right now in Jesus' name. We come against any of your devices, any of your plans. We break it back tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that this lockdown will stop in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. We command it to stop now in Jesus' name, Lord. We still declare that God is first, Lord. We will put you first no matter what they say, no matter what they ask us to do, Lord. We will be a church. We will be a body. We will be a movement, Father God, that will run with the fire of Christ within us, that will go and impart it to the youth, to the generations, Father God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Lord, every mental illness that has spring forth in this time, Lord, we come down. Every mental illness, we break your works and your operations in the lives of the people now in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare a sound mind. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we also come and we pray against a spirit of suicide. You spirit of suicide, you listen to my voice. We command you to loose and go. Go in the name of Jesus. We rebuke your operations now in the name of Jesus Christ. No more, no more, no more, no more. Lord, we seal the believers. We seal the people with your blood, Lord. Lord, I pray your protection, Lord, over every person that's joining us in prayer now, Lord. Lord, I declare and I plead your blood over every believer now watching, Lord. Now joining us, part of this family, Lord, the body of Christ, Lord. I plead your blood over them, over their loved ones, Lord, over their businesses, over their children, Lord. Over every aspect of their life, their marriages, Lord. Lord, we plead your blood over their marriages, over their finances, Lord. We declare your protection, Lord, now, over their vehicles, wherever they may travel, Lord, that you will keep them safe, Lord. Their health, we plead the blood of Jesus over every aspect, over every aspect. Thank you, Lord. Will someone please pray for us for healing?
Amen. Hallelujah. I just want to read a scripture to you. It is out of Exodus 23, verse 25. It says, it's what I prayed earlier on, but here's the scripture. It says, worship the Lord your God, and his blessing will be on your food and water. And it says further, I will take away sickness from among you. No matter what might be going on around us, no matter how dark the darkness might seem to get, there is nothing more powerful than our God. There's nothing more powerful than the name of Jesus. There's nothing more powerful powerful than the weapons that God has given us. So in the mighty name of Jesus tonight, Lord, we come and we lift you up and we exalt you. We praise you. We come and give you all glory, Father. And I declare healing in this church's people, Father God, tonight in their bodies, Lord, wherever they've been stricken with sickness, Father God, wherever they've been struggling, Lord, wherever they've been feeling ill or family that's felt ill, Lord, we just speak healing over them in the mighty name of Jesus. By your stripes we are healed, Father, and we receive it tonight. We stand upon it tonight, Lord. We thank you. I thank you now for your healing upon everybody, Lord, upon every sickness, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
You know what? I don't know if I should share this, but now that there's so many people unfortunately passing away, and many are believers. I mean, there's pastors passing away and things like that happening, and many people don't understand these things, and it leaves people feeling worried, feeling like they've lost faith, having more questions and things. But you know, we will never really truly know now why. But I want to share with you some story, and it just expounds our carnal way of thinking, because we're always trying to find an answer, a logic answer to things, which we will not, unfortunately, always find now while we are here on the earth. But when we graduate one day to heaven, this is what I want to share also. And you know what? Just remember that when somebody passes away, because we are dealing with so much death around us right now, everybody somewhere is experiencing this now, and it's devastating and it's heartbreaking and it's all these things. But this is a good time once again to be a Christian. If you are a believer, it's not final. Death is not final. You are graduating to be with your Heavenly Father, awaiting the rest of the believers to get back. Amen. You are just that person that has passed away is just a step ahead of all of us. And you know, it's sad for the people staying behind, because they are grieving and they're experiencing loss and going through all of these things that's really, really hard. But that person that was saved, that is now in heaven, is rejoicing. Oh, yes. And what is already feeling like for us for a long time feels only like minutes or seconds to them in heaven, because time is so different. So they are experiencing amazing new things. I can promise you, if you probably prayed for that person to come back to life, they would tell you, why did you bring me back? I was enjoying myself. Leave me. Let me go. Because they are experiencing the greatness and the presence of God. I don't think when you enter the presence of God, you ever want to turn back. Amen. Because it is so amazing. You know, I know of people. There was there's two stories like that I just want to share with you. This one lady prayed for her son. Somebody told me this week, and she's probably watching. She prayed for her son to get saved. So he got saved, and then he got into a serious accident, and he was not doing well. It looked like he was going to not make it. And then she prayed and she prayed and she pleaded with God, God, do not take my son, do not take my son. And God warned her of what she's praying, because, you know, we tend to pray our will instead of God's perfect will. And she kept on pressing with God, and she kept on pressing with God, so he was healed. He made it. But he got backslidden. And then he passed away. And that mother has that regret to this day, that she has prayed that. Because, you know, sometimes we are so intensely asking God for things, but we are not thinking about His perfect will. And He always knows what's better for us. Although I can imagine as a mother doing that, that's your natural instinct. But I'm not telling this of the decision that she made. I'm just telling you that we don't know always the reason why it's somebody's time to go. Sometimes the enemy just steals. You know, there can be so many reasons, but only God knows. Only God knows. Amen. But that is the thing. If your family members are not saved yet, pray, pray, pray. And we are praying with you. Pray that they shall be saved. Because we as believers are not like the people of the world without hope. Amen. We have the assurance that we have eternal life, and that we are one day to see each other again. Amen. We have eternal life. And you know what? Maybe you are backslidden and you feel far from God, or maybe even you have never given your life to Jesus Christ. I want to give you this opportunity to make right with Him. Amen. To accept Him as your Lord and Savior. Amen. And it's so easy to do. You know what? Never feel like you're not good enough, because Jesus died on the cross for you so that you may be saved. He already knew what you were going to do and the marks that we all miss. But God, or Jesus, died on the cross for you. Amen. So you may have eternal life. Amen. So I just need you there where you are now. Just raise your hands and join me in this prayer. Jesus,
tonight
I come
and I repent
of all my sins of missing the mark. Forgive me where I have rejected you. But tonight I call upon
your name
That I may too
be saved
by the grace
of God.
I declare that Jesus Christ
is the Messiah
and my Lord and Savior. I thank you for my salvation. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You know what? This is how easy it is to lead somebody to Jesus Christ. So if there's a working employee maybe next to you, a fellow employee or somebody that you know and they need Jesus, or it's the cashier at the shop, it's as quickly as that. We need to get souls saved. Amen. We know that Jesus will soon return, but even now, people are passing away or things are just happening. And I don't know if you've noticed, people are not just passing away of COVID. There are many deaths still happening outside of COVID. Even young people, different ages, that's just passing away. Amen. We all must make sure that our life is right with God. And when your life is right with God, how do you know? You'll have that peace, that knowing that you are ready to go home to graduate. If it should happen to you now, you are ready. Amen. If it happens in 80 years, you are still ready. Amen. And that is, you can hear people sometimes, they say, yeah, I am. But if you ask them, will you go to heaven? Where are you going when you pass away? They cannot give you an answer. Because the term Christian has become a cheap term. Amen. That word Christian will not get you access to heaven. It's Jesus Christ, only through Jesus Christ, that you can get to heaven, to call upon His name as Lord and Savior of your life. Amen. So please, let us have compassion upon the people around us. There are many caught in destruction and distress and a lot of things. But this is, the harvest is plentiful. Lord, I also come now and I pray for every person watching now, Lord, that you will activate the laborers, Lord. Let them be obedient, Lord, to the commission you have given us, Lord, and get the people into the kingdom of God, Lord. We declare it, Lord, the soul safe, Lord. Lord, I pray now, Lord, that you will come to them, Lord, that you will speak to them, that you will show them who you want them to go and pray for and reach for your kingdom, Lord. We declare it now, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we declare the family members safe, Lord. We declare the children saved in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know what? Sometimes some people might go through difficulties, but sometimes that's the only way they will get saved. You know, some people, I have seen this. Look at Israel, what they did with God. When they were persecuted and things were really going tough. Lord, we need you, we need you. And then God shows up. And when things are going good or whatever, they just forget about it. And then it's like the cycle human beings have. In the beginning of COVID last year, we need God. And you know, and then after a while, then people forget. Let that not be us. Amen. Let's call upon the name of the Lord every day. Amen. And just fall in love with Him all over again. Lord, I pray now that your presence will fill every house, Lord. Every house, Lord. Lord, let them experience your love and your compassion now, Lord. Lord, I pray more than ever before that we, as believers, Lord, will reveal Christ-likeness to the world, Lord. Your love and your compassion to our neighbors, Lord. Lord, I pray now, Lord, that we will not operate in our carnal and selfish ways, Lord. Forgive us for that, Lord. But that we will operate through the Spirit of God to reach your people, Lord. Lord, that we will show and take your light out to the people, Lord. We declare it now. Thank you, Lord. You know what, Michelle, will you please pray for people that has gone through loss and that doesn't know how to deal with it. Because, you know, grief, it's... And, you know, even regret, where people might have regret. Maybe they couldn't say goodbye to their loved one, or they felt like they didn't spend enough time with them, or, you know, there can be many... Just pray for that restoration and healing for them now. Because this is tough times for people losing. I mean, it's no joke losing somebody. Though we know when they are believers, but that they will just know and have that peace and that healing. Amen. And that the Spirit of God just be there to comfort them.
Father, Lord Jesus, we just come in this evening, Father, and we pray for each and every person and individual that has experienced loss, Father, a family member lost to death. Father, we pray, Father, that they will be healed and restored in Jesus' name, Father. I pray that you will touch them, Father, and that your Holy Spirit will invade them, Father, that they will know that it's not actually a loss, Father, but that they are just one step ahead, like Pastor said. Father, and I pray that you will just give them that peace, Father, every regret. We come against that, Father God. Where you just feel like it's your fault or you could have done more. I pray against that, Father, and I pray that the people will forgive themselves, Father, and that they will just look to you and that they will be restored, that they will seek your face, Father, because in your presence is where we are restored. In your presence is where we are made whole. So I pray, Father, that each and every individual experiencing loss, Father, that they will just go into your presence and seek your face and just ask you to be restored them, Father, because there's no one that can restore like you do, Father. I pray, Father, that they will go to you for the solution, that they will go to you to be restored, and that they will not look for any solution or restoration in the world, Father, but that they will listen to your voice. I pray, Father, that your love, that your Spirit of love will just fill them and overflow, Father. I pray, Lord Jesus, that they will see this in a whole different way, that you will open their eyes, Father God, to the things unseen, so that they will understand why they are going through this, Father. I pray, Lord Jesus, where they have questions that are unanswered, Father, that you will give them a peace at heart, that they will know that it's your will, Father God, and your will only, Father. I pray that they will just feel your love and your experience, your goodness and your grace, Father, that they will know it's never your will to hurt or for them to go through this, Father, but just to be stronger. I pray, Father, that they will just be restored in Jesus' name. I pray for your presence and your love to fill them, because that's the only thing that can bring anyone through this, Father. And I pray anyone that has had that loss, Father, that they will use this to learn, Father, so that they can help those around them experiencing the same loss, Father, that they will be able to help fellow believers through this. I decree and declare this in your almighty name. Amen and amen.
Lord, I pray that heaven will become more a reality to us, Lord. Lord, that we will know, Lord, that you are awaiting, Lord, that you are waiting for your bride and for your children, Lord. Lord, that it will be such a reality for us, Lord. Let this carnal flesh, Lord, let this carnal flesh of us die, Lord, so that our spirits may live, Lord, and that we stand on your truth, Lord, on your word and on your promises, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that will be our reality. Lord, there are so many carnal things happening now, Lord. But again, Lord, we pray that our flesh be crucified, Lord, so that our spirits may live, Lord, and our faith be increased in the mighty name of Jesus.
We hunger, oh God, for your revival in this nation, oh God, and around the world, Father. We pray that you begin to spark, Lord, that you'd begin to spark the flames of revival in each and every home, Father, that your people will be hungry for more of you, Father. We declare right now, God, that revival is our portion. And right now we know, God, that this climate that we are in is a perfect climate for your revival. Right now we also just decree and declare Isaiah 60 that says, arise and shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. We declare right now, God, that the church would arise right now, that the laborers would arise right now in Jesus' name. We pray, Father, that you'd begin to activate your laborers once again, Father, that they would come to you and know that you are the one true living God. We pray that even as the church comes to you, may they also come back on their knees. We declare right now, God, that your glory to fill the earth, oh God, as the waters covers the seas, Father. We just declare right now that revival is our portion. We declare, Father, that the fires of revival will spread far and wide, oh God, across the earth, Father, that souls will come to you in Jesus' name. We declare that salvation is your people's portion. We declare that every knee will bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We thank you, revival, and we speak it upon our families, upon those who do not know you, Father, that they would come to Christ and receive from you, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name.
Yes, Lord, tonight, Lord, we are also coming in unity and interceding, Lord, for everybody that's in the front lines, Lord. Lord, for our police officers, Lord. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you will strengthen them, Lord, to raise them even up, Lord, to serve you, Lord, and to protect your people, Lord, that you'll give them the wisdom also that they need and the guidance, Lord, that your word will be a lamp unto their feet, Lord. Lord, and that you will cover them and protect them, Lord. Cover them and protect them, Lord. And Lord, that you will keep them healthy and keep them safe, Lord. Same for our army, Lord, that has been deployed, Lord, that you will help them, strengthen them, Lord, in these times when they cannot be with their families, Lord, when they have to work overtime, Lord, and maybe have sleepless and long nights, Lord, and work with difficult people. Lord, we pray that you'll also give them the wisdom and protection, Lord, and be with them. Your spirit be with them, Lord, that you will help them. Lord, our doctors, our nurses, even the admin in the hospitals, Lord, all the people that's employed there, Lord. Lord, we pray your protection over them, Lord, your blood, your covering, Lord, that you will strengthen them, Lord, that you'll keep them safe and healthy, Lord, that COVID will not be their portion, Lord. Lord, that you will also give them the wisdom to help people and to speak the truth, Lord. Lord, I pray that your truth will be upon every health worker's tongue, Lord. Your truth will be upon every police officer's tongue, Lord. And your truth be on every army's tongue, Lord, person's tongue, Lord. Lord, that your truth will fill their hearts, Lord. And Lord, that your spirit will come upon them and begin revival within them also, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the great work that thou do. Lord, bless the work of their hands, Lord. We thank you, Lord, giving them medical breakthroughs, Lord, in the hospitals. We declare it, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I'm also praying for the president tonight, Lord. Lord, despite what is going on and many not agreeing with him and difficult decisions and things, Lord, Lord, we pray now that you'll give him the strength to stand up to do what is right, Lord. Lord, that he will hide under the shadow of your wings, Lord. That will be the place where he finds comfort, Lord. Let him seek your counsel and your body's counsel, Lord. Give the Church of South Africa an ear and favor with the president and the government, Lord. Lord, I pray that the president will have a fresh encounter with you, Lord, that he will be a man that is known to be on his knees before God, seeking your face before he makes decisions, Lord. I pray that your fear will be with him, Lord, and that your spirit will be with him and strengthen him, Lord, and guide him, and Holy Spirit, that you will convict him where need be, Lord, and let him be a lover of your presence, Lord, and let him also put God first, Lord, and help him to become the president which you have meant for him to be, Lord, that he will step into that position, Lord, boldly, Lord, and not be afraid of the voices of the ones and of the darkness around him, Lord, but that he will rise up within in Christ, Lord, to lead this nation, Lord, in righteousness and justice of the Lord, Lord. We pray and we call upon your name, Lord, and that you fill his heart with love and compassion, Lord. And that you will lead him and bring comfort to him as well, Lord. Lord, if there are wrong decisions made, Lord, those people, Lord, that is making decisions that's ungodly, I pray that they will not be able to sleep, but that they will stay awake. Their beds be hard, Lord. Lord, that you will deal with them swiftly, Lord. We declare it, Lord, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that they too shall be saved in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, we thank you for this beautiful nation, Lord. We want to end this night in prayer, Lord. We thank you for this beautiful nation of South Africa. Lord, we thank you that we have been born here, that we have been raised here, Lord, and that you use us here. Thank you for our purpose in this nation. Thank you for every person's purpose within this nation, Lord, that they will walk in that purpose within this nation, Lord. Lord, we declare, Lord, that again, once again, in unity, and we prophesy South Africa, you shall live. We pray healing and restoration in this nation in every aspect, Lord, from the economy, Lord, to the health, Lord, of this nation, Lord, to the unity in this nation, Lord, that the spirit of racism shall fail and those inciting racism will be brought down in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your love filling this nation, Lord, from the north to the south, from the east to the west, Lord. We declare it in the mighty name, and we declare provision for South Africa, Lord. Overflow of God's goodness for South Africa, Lord. That, Lord, for the goodness of God leads men to repentance, Lord, that we may repent, Lord, in this nation, Lord, and we know the goodness of God, Lord. We thank you for people rising up all over South Africa and even starting to publicly worship, Lord. We pray that that will happen more, Lord, and that people will ignite and stand strong, Lord, no matter what comes, Lord, but that the people will be filled with the Spirit of God and with the joy of the Lord. For, Lord, your joy is our strength, Lord. Our joy is found in you, Lord. Thank you for your joy, Lord, and we grab hold of it, and we give you the glory and the honor, and thank you for the privilege of living in this day and age and fighting the good fight of faith, Lord. We will continually faithfully serve you, Lord, and to do your perfect will and your command, Lord. We surrender our wills to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Amen. We trust that you have enjoyed this evening of prayer with us. We enjoyed it, amen. And we are trusting God. We are going to see what God's going to do in South Africa. Amen. There might be difficult times, but oh boy, are we going to have good testimonies. Let me tell you that we will testify of God's goodness, amen. If the Lord was taking too long to come back, he won't. It's going to be soon. They will be writing books of how God changed things in South Africa. Amen. Amen. It will be historical of what God is going to do for South Africa. For we are known as Dark Africa. We will be the light.
Yeah,
we will be the light upon the hill. The safe, the place of safety for others to run to. Amen. For South Africa will hide in the shadow of the Almighty's wings in the name of Jesus. South Africa shall live. Yeah, yes, Pastor, your name. South Africa shall live. Amen. Now, family, I declare you're blessed. We see you. Do not forget about Sunday morning service at 9 a.m., evening service at 5 p.m., only live. But we trust and we declare in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, that you will open your church never to be closed again, so that we can freely gather without limitations and worship you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare and we agree, amen. So we trust we will see you all soon, but Sunday, do not miss the online services. And we cannot wait. We are excited. And I trust that you are excited. There's excitement in your spirit. Amen. Let me tell you, it's a good time to be a Christian. And oh boy, it's such a privilege to think about it, to be alive in this time, to be that remnant that God can use to bring change. Amen. So thank you for being a faithful servant to the Lord. Amen. And keep on running your race strong. Amen. Love you all. Bye-bye.